Hey everyone, I'm Melanie from Streamline Legal, where we help law firms get the most out of their practice management software. Tonight I'm talking about time blocking. And for those of you that are not familiar, time blocking essentially means marking time off on your calendar to reserved to do certain things. So for example, and it's not necessarily an appointment that you're keeping with someone else. It's more an appointment that you're keeping with yourself. So for example, if I had a document to prepare, and I knew it was going to take me approximately 45 minutes to prepare this document, I would go over to my calendar and I would block off 45 minutes to prepare the document. Or alternatively, if I knew that I was trying to prioritize marketing within my business, then I could say every Thursday from 2 to 4, I'm going to work on marketing. And I'd go to my calendar and I would block it off and I would spend that time marketing for the business. And so it can be a really, really effective tool. But of course, there are some caveats. You have to abide by what your calendar says. If you're just looking at the calendar and you sabotage yourself by not doing what's on the calendar, then obviously this technique is not going to work. So there is one trick that I've found that makes this a lot easier that I wanted to share with you guys. And so I'm going to head over to our Clio over here. This does not have to be done in Clio. This is just the example that I have, but this technique can work with a practice management software, a task management software, no software at all. This could be just done with written procedures or just by verbally telling someone. So let's talk through it a bit. So this is a scenario you see on the screen where I have a document that I'm drafting, and in fact, I'm not drafting it, my associate is drafting it, and my associate's going to go ahead and review some intake notes. Then the associate's going to draft the petition. Then it's my job to go ahead and review that petition. And so this is where a lot of attorneys get bottlenecked, right? This is where a lot of the workflow gets bottlenecked when the attorneys need to review the documentation that someone else in the office has prepared. And so that's the example we've got here. And then, of course, as soon as I do review it, then we can send it off to be filed. And that's the last task in this workflow. So, like I said, this does not have to even be done with technology. This is just the example that I have, taken from a very real life example. So, in this situation, you'll see we've got these different tasks, but here is the key to this. And that's right here in task number two, where we say draft the petition. If you look at that task very closely, I've got some instructions here to use a template. But then I've also got instructions for this person to block off 30 minutes of time somewhere in the next 3 days on the reviewing attorney's calendar. So we are enabling other people, empowering other people to go ahead and put that time aside for us on the calendar. And so what this person would do now is when this task popped up and they draft the petition, and the last thing they do before they mark it as complete is they come over to the calendar, and of course, you have to give them permission to edit your calendar. They're going to come over here and see, okay, they're going to draft it on the 2nd. And so we'll go head over to the next week. I've got some time on the 5th and the 6th, so they can go ahead and find a 30-minute slot to go ahead and put in my review petition. And what really this does is it takes it away from us. Sometimes we are the people standing in our way. Sometimes we are the log jam in getting work done. And so this empowers other people to set that priority for us or help us keep the priorities that we've already decided that we want to keep. So again, this does not require any kind of technology. The idea is that if we're empowering other people to help hold us to the commitments that we want to make, then they can really come in handy and help us. And so again, the whole idea is that if we have a workflow that involves some type of review or involves some type of step that we have an estimate for how long it's going to take, then in order to not let the day get away with us, or get away from us, I should say, and to keep to that really that priority of getting work through the firm, I would highly recommend that you use this technique to have somebody else time block for you. So as they create documents, as they come across things that need to be reviewed, have a standing set of time frames that say, if I'm reviewing a complaint, set aside this time. If I'm reviewing a petition, go ahead and set aside 20 minutes. If it's a motion, go ahead and set aside 40 minutes or whatever. It may not be perfect, but guess what? It is going to reserve that time for you. And then, of course, your trick is to go ahead and live by your calendar. I hope you find this helpful. Please do give it a try and let me know how it works out. I'll see you guys soon. Have a great evening.